Hi, I'm Ben Marriott. I make weekly motion design and animation tutorials, and today I'm going to talk through how to set up this effect to smash absolutely anything in After Effects. Let's begin. Alright, so we've got our comp set up with a lollipop ready to smash our object. I've animated this on a 2 second loop, and I've got the impact of the lollipop smashing happening at the very first frame. Now if we click on our rotation and go into our graph editor, we can see how that looks like in here. So it goes down gradually, and then at the end sort of picks up, ready for another swing. I've also got a bit of animation on the shadows of the lollipop here as well. You can download this project file and have a closer look at those two, but let's focus on the smashing effect for now. I'm going to shy all these layers so we're only paying attention to our smashed object and the null we've got here. So I've got my tooth layer, which is an Illustrator file over here. So I've just drawn this in Illustrator and imported it in. You could also use a shape layer, you could use a photo, a text, a comp, even video footage, and I'm going to show you later how we can quickly swap out all our objects to make the smash effect apply to anything at all. Now first let's pre-comp this tooth with Ctrl-Shift-C, and let's call this tooth, and let's move this into position. So at the very first frame, we want to make contact with our lollipop. And we want that to happen right in the center. So let's zoom in and just nudge it with our arrow tools here. So here is where our tooth is going to make impact at the beginning. But we also need to animate it coming in from screen left. So I'm going to duplicate this comp with Control D. And then I'm going to animate its position property here. If we play that back, we can see generally how the timing of this animation is going to play out. I'm going to duplicate this bottom tooth comp with Control D. And then I'm going to rename that Shard 01. This is going to become the first shard of this tooth as it smashes. This bottom tooth layer, I'm going to use only as a reference layer. So I'm going to click on T and bring the transparency down to maybe 20%. I'm also going to use an image of smashed glass as some reference here. So I'm going to scale this up and I'm going to take the transparency of that down to maybe 20% as well. I want to move it into position to get some more interesting shapes here. And this is just so we can see what kind of shapes, like actual glass smashing, will look like. And you can use sort of a crumbly concrete or some more debris or anything else to get the type of shard shapes you'd like. And let's lock this layer so we don't accidentally move it. And let's change the color of these so we can see what they are at a glance. So let's select our pen tool up here. And we're gonna draw our first shard by creating a mask. I'm gonna start on the top right corner of our comp here. And just by clicking, I'm gonna create a mask that's gonna be roughly a similar sort of shape to what these broken glass shards are here. And now that we've closed up our mask, we've got this one piece of our comp selected. To create our second shard, I'm going to duplicate this comp with Control D. It'll automatically rename itself, which is very handy. And I'm just going to drag these right sort of, the right points of this mask tool and drag them over to the left. And line them up to create sort of a second shard here. Now I'm not going to touch the ones on the right, which we're making up the left side of our shard one. And this means that they will line up exactly. So make sure not to move these sides. And for shard three, I'm going to duplicate this again, move the anchor points around another time. And you can even add some more points if you want to get some more variation in here. I'm just going to continue doing this clockwise around the tooth until we get back to the other side. Okay, now I've got all of our shards. Let's go and delete this smashed glass layer because we don't need that. And let's delete our bottom tooth reference layer because we won't need that either. And now let's go and split some of these shards up so they just look a little bit more broken. To do that, I'm going to select shard 3 and I'm going to solo this layer by clicking it over here. So now that's the only layer visible. So I'm going to select our pen tool again and I'm just going to draw a mask that's just going to split this layer in half. But it doesn't quite split it in two. It adds this section back that we'd already hidden. That is because both masks are set to add. If we press M on our keyboard, it'll show our mask properties here. And both are set to add. So what that means is each shape that I've drawn with the mask tool here is adding back to what area of the comp is visible. So if we change our second mask to subtract, it will subtract it and remove that section, just like we want. The order that the masks are in will also affect this. After Effects applies the masks from the top down, so it will add mask 1 and then subtract mask 2. But if we move mask 2 above, we get a completely different result. It's subtracting this pink shape that we've drawn, and then it's adding back this sort of cyan sort of triangle lightning bolt shape on top of that as well. So let's swap those back. And let's rename this shard 3A, and let's duplicate that with Command D and call this shard 03B. And I'm gonna grab these handles of the mask and flip them over. So it's gonna draw the second half. And if we nudge shard 03B, you can see that this section is now split into two. Let's move those back. This method makes sure that there are no gaps between any of our pieces. Let's unsolder those, and I might do that for a couple more pieces down here as well. So now that we've got all our shards, let's animate them smashing outwards. So I'm going to select all of them, holding shift, and I'm going to press P to bring up my position property, and let's go to 1 second in, and we're going to move them into their final position. So I'm going to select each layer, and then I'm just going to drag with my arrow tool, drag it out away from this impact area. I'll do that for all the layers. Alright, now I've made sure to spread them out evenly, so there's roughly the same negative space between each one. Even the shards have split into two. Now let's watch back and see what it looks like. Alright, we can see it's kind of getting there. Now we need to add some nice easing to this smash animation. I want to add a really steep easing to this impact. So I'm going to just drag up our timeline here, and I'm going to select all of our keyframes, and I'm going to press F9 to put an easy ease on them. And let's go into our graph editor. So with all these keyframes selected, I'm going to push this one to the left, and then push this one to the left also. Now that's as far as it goes, so let's see how that one looks. That's not bad. I think I actually want this to go over a little bit more of a time, so let's drag these back keyframes over again even further to the right. This animation will happen over a longer period of time. And there we are, I think that's looking pretty good now. Now at the end here, we've got these sort of pieces just cutting away before our next tooth flies in. It's up to you how you'd like to animate them, sort of moving off screen. You can do them sort of animating into a sliver of nothing with a mask property. So if you press M, keyframe your mask path, and then towards the end here, you can simply draw the path sort of being reduced to nothing. If we do that for a few shards, let's see what that looks like. So this has them sort of slivering into invisibility just before the next tooth comes in. If you'd like them to fall down, like some shadow things would naturally in real life physics, you can keyframe their position a little bit later on, drag them down off screen. You need to play with the easing to make that look a little bit more natural. Now the benefit of using a composition and slicing this all up in masks rather than, you know, slicing it up in Illustrator or another program beforehand is that you can go and swap out the object being smashed here. You can simply open the comp, drag in another asset, hide the tooth comp, and if we go out, you see it all updates and animates procedurally. So you can smash absolutely anything you like. An image, smash avocado, smash text, even Billy Corgan. The possibilities are endless. This project file is available for download down in the description. If you've used anything you've learned in this video, please tag me at Ben_Marriott_ on Instagram so I can see what you've smashed and shared it. Please let me know down in the comments what else you'd like to see from this channel. And don't forget to subscribe, hit that bell icon, like, share, but check out this playlist of other related tutorials. I'll see you in the next video.